Die Kutsche wartet.
Komm!
Come in.
Herr Knight. There are some people here to see you.
Me?
Yeah, if you please come.
What's going on? You've been acting strange all day.
Please, just come. And don't forget your talisman. You must wear it always.
Damn thing's heavy. Well, hello there. Shouldn't those be torches?
Guten Abend, Herr Knight. I am Werner Huber. Forgive our coming here so late, but we must speak with you.
What can I do for you? Oh,
this is my cousin, the Huber Sepp. He has a farm just outside of Munich. I will tell you the truth, Herr Knight. We have come for the Schattenjäger.
I see. What makes you think you need a Schattenjäger?
It is because of Sepp here. Two nights ago, his wife goes to the window of the house to call in their daughter, Tony. It is getting dark. The light outside is not so good, yeah? She sees Tony some meters away, playing in the grass. And she sees a wolf. It is huge. And it is moving. Towards the child. Mutter screams to the child, warning.
Five!
And that is when the beast strikes.
Tony!
Oh, no, langsam, langsam. They say she died quickly. Sepp here hears his wife screaming, comes running from the barn. He sees the wolf, goes inside the house to get a gun. But when he comes out, no wolf. And it has taken part of the child with it.
That's horrible.
Yeah, yeah, it is very bad, Herr Knight. That is why we come to you.
Haven't the police been notified?
Well, yeah, natürlich. The police, they think it is wolves escaped from a zoo. They search and search, but they find nothing. This is not the first such killing. But if it is not stopped, it will not be the last.
I'm not really sure what you want me to do.
The killer is not wolf. It is werewolf. You must hunt it down and kill it.
Werewolf? What makes you think it's a werewolf?
The wolf looked at me. Its eyes were human. It knew what it was doing. It knew.
I'm really very sorry about your daughter, Herr Huber.
I have told them that you are the new Schattenjäger.
You wear the talisman. Are you the Schattenjäger now, or are you not?
I am.
We do not know you, Herr Knight, but we have known the Schattenjägers for many centuries. It is to them we turn in trouble like this. Sepp here is family. Will you come? Just look around, see what you can see. Huh? Sepp and his wife go north to be with her mother. You can stay on his farm.
All right. I'll look into it for you. See what I can see.
I'll pack your things.
Great. Thanks. I'll meet you in the village in an hour.
Oh, thank you, Herr Knight. Thank you.
I told you I will if this doesn't work out. There's still a couple of months before they close applications. No, I don't know that yet. Mom, will you please speak English? I'm not a sales clerk. I don't know what you should tell them. Just tell them that I'm going to be here a while longer. I'm not ready for that yet. I have to go, Mom. I have to go. I'll call you later. Love you. Bye. Sorry.
Oh, that's all right. I just love Blake Backlash, don't you?
He's something all right.
Oh, he's so masculine and so handsome and, well, sexy. It just about took my breath away when he seduced that female sidekick of his. What is her name?
Fujitsu.
That's right, Fuji, he called her. You have read the book.
That'll be $24.50.
She just melted, didn't she? Fuji, I mean. They just don't make men like that anymore.
You would think so, wouldn't you?
Is it true that the author owns this bookstore?
That's what they tell me.
Of course, he must be awfully busy. Say, is there a good time when I might stop by? You know, if I wanted to get a look at him?
I wouldn't if I were you. He's awfully shy. It's his face. There was an accident.
Oh.
A terrible accident.
Oh. Thank you.
Gracie, something's come up. I'm on a new case. Too bad you're not here to help, but Gerda can handle any research I need. I know I have a lot to decide, but that and the new book are going to have to wait. I have a feeling this is important.
Gerda. I don't think so. I need to see Gabriel, please.
I'm sorry, Herr Knight's not here.
Great.
You must be Grace. I think we spoke on the phone.
Uh-huh. When is Gabriel due back?
I don't know. He's gone for some time. Maybe you would like to stay at the castle and wait for him?
I don't have much choice, do I?
I can't read much of it, but they give the name of the zoo. The name of the detective on the case is Leber. Jesus, it's as big as my hand. It'll take a minute to set. Thank you.
Ja. Wollen Sie was von mir? Kann ich Ihnen was helfen?
Guten Tag. Do you speak English?
Na, das war schön. Also, was wollen Sie denn von mir?
Great. Leber. Criminal Commissar Leber. Is he here?
Kommissar Leber? Und was wollen Sie von dem, wenn ich fragen darf? Ist der schwerhörig oder was? Wer? Sie sind?
Sie. Me. Oh.
Ja.
Oh. Right.
Na endlich.
Writer. You know, books. That's me.
Ja.
Kommissar Leber, bitte. Sie, da möchte ich noch einen Bier verkaufen. Tut mir leid, unser Kommissar Leber lässt einen ausrichten, er hat schon ein Buch. Und ein anderes braucht er nicht. Nein, der hat nämlich einen Haffer zum Tor. Er ist zu beschäftigt. Auf Wiedersehen. Sie brauchen einen bloß umdrehen, da hinten ist die Tür.
Right, thanks.
Tja, Bücher lesen sowas.
Here, Wolf. Come on, Wolf. Come on. Come on. Come on, boy. Here, Wolfie. Come on. Come on, Wolfie, Wolfie. Come on. Come on. Get the heck over here, will ya?
Like that, is it? Excuse me, do you speak English?
Yes.
Great. Mind if I ask you some questions?
Yeah, okay.
Have you worked here long?
Thomas. Almost one whole year.
A year? Wow. I noticed you were pretty calm walking in that kennel. Guess wild animals don't bother you, huh?
The wolves. They're lazy during the day.
These wolves are fascinating, aren't they? I tried calling one over, but they weren't too obliging.
Yeah, some people try that all day.
Is there any chance you could take me inside the kennel? I'd really like to see one of the wolves up close, kind of a research thing.
No way. No one will enter the kennel without authorization.
I suppose you were around when those wolves escaped.
No, I don't work at night.
But you must have been here the next day, right? That people were pretty upset, what with the police and everything?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, that day was super crazy.
So how'd the wolves escape, anyway?
Well, the gate was left open after the night feeding. The gate is heavy, it shuts itself. Maybe something was in the way, maybe a rock, I don't know. I'm only glad it was not me there. The boy who works that night has been... You know?
Oh, fire. So, what do you think about these killings? Pretty scary, huh? Do you ever think those two wolves could do something like this?
I don't believe it is possible. Hilda and Parsifal were fine with me, just like all the other wolves. Hilda, she liked to play. She was so young still.
What did the two missing wolves look like, anyway?
Hilda was pretty. She had much white on her chest. And Parsifal, he was bigger, thicker, more in the chest. He was 5 or 6 years old, maybe. Much darker than Hilda.
Dark? Dark what?
Dark gray. Most were gray. Most of the wolves here are.
So you carry a walkie-talkie?
The zoo is big.
Who normally gives you your instructions over that thing?
Kitchen, sometimes the health unit. For something really important, a Dr. Klingman himself will call me.
Who's this Dr. Klingman you mentioned?
Dr. Klingman is in charge of the mammal division.
So I should speak to him about seeing the wolves up close.
You can try, but he won't let you.
Perhaps. Where could I find him?
In the administration area.
Hey, thank you for your time.
Whatever.
Come and see. Kann ich Ihnen helfen?
I'm afraid my German isn't very good. My name's Gabriel Knight. I'm an American novelist.
What can I do for you, Mr. Knight?
I'm researching a new book, and I hear you're the expert in these parts. Could you spare a moment?
Please, sit down.
Thank you. Could I ask you some questions?
Yes.
Thanks. You don't mind if I record this, do you?
That's fine.
So, you're in charge of the zoo's mammal divisions?
Yes.
What kind of training do you need for that, Doc?
I realize you Americans hate titles, but people refer to me as Herr Dr. Klingman here. Herr Doctor will also do.
Sorry.
I have a doctorate from Heidelberg University. My field is animal behaviorist.
Fascinating. I see you're particularly interested in wolves.
Yes, I'm quite well known for my wolf research.
You must have been horrified when two of your wolves escaped then.
Yes, it has been very unsettling.
I was speaking with one of your boys out front, Greg, was it?
No, there's no Greg on staff here. Do you mean Thomas?
Thomas, right. Anyway, he's the one that said to talk to you. Because I was wondering if there was any way I could get a closer look at one of the wolves for research.
I'm afraid this is not possible. We don't show our wolves to anyone. We must protect what privacy the creatures have.
Really? Well, gosh. I guess that's that. Do you mind if we talk briefly about the missing wolves?
Is this relevant to your book?
Oh, yeah. You see, wolves are major characters in my new novel, and this case is quite unusual, isn't it?
I suppose it is. Very well. Actually, I know very little about the case, but I will tell you what I can.
Appreciate it. How long have the wolves been missing?
It's been about 2 months.
Jeez, whew, that's a while, isn't it? It's strange the police haven't seen hide nor hair of them, so to speak.
Believe me, your sentiment is shared by the German public.
Do you think the zoo wolves are responsible for the mutilation killings?
That is yet to be proven.
Because I've been wondering, what else could it be? Wild wolves, maybe?
Unfortunately, there are very few wild wolves left in Germany. Most were killed off by hunters decades ago.
Most?
A few remain in the Alps. But so close to a city like Munich, it's highly unlikely.
What I don't see is why wolves, if the killers are wolves, why wolves would attack humans.
Wolves are predators. Most carnivores are potential man-eaters, given hunger enough and opportunity.
But weren't the zoo wolves raised among humans?
Yes. And therefore, they are not afraid of us.
Thank you for your time, Doctor.
Not at all.
Entschuldigung, ich hab nicht gewusst, dass jemand hier ist. Ich soll an dem Kamin arbeiten.
Ja, it's okay. Fangen Sie ruhig an.
Where is Gabriel?
I don't know exactly.
Surely he said something when he left. You must have been here when his new case came up.
I was here.
What was it about? Was it around here?
All I know is that he was going somewhere near Munich.
You must know something about Gabriel's new case.
It is not my business to talk or not talk about it. Gabriel took the case for someone else.
Really? Who?
Werner Huber. He runs the Gasthof in town.
Gabriel mentioned in his letter that... Well, normally I do research for him. It's more or less my field, and if there's anything he needs to get done, I'd be happy to take care of it.
He did ask me to check some things for him, but I couldn't let someone else do the work.
I understand, really. But if Gabriel knew that I was already here, see, that I was around, he'd want me to do it.
I'm sorry. If I do hear from him, I'll ask him what he would prefer. Until then, I must do the work he asks me to do.
I'm curious. I mean, I was just wondering. What was it Gabriel asked you to research?
Just some things.
Some things about?
He asked me to check the Schattenjäger library for any record of other cases about... I cannot discuss the case with you. I'm sorry, but that's just the way it is. Why don't you go look around the area? I'm sure you could find something to do.
Gerda, there's a locked door in Gabriel's bedroom. Do you know where it goes?
It goes to the Schattenjäger library.
That's where all the Schattenjäger records are kept?
Yes.
Why is the door locked?
Gabriel doesn't want the workmen in there.
Oh. Can I get the key?
No. The library is for Schattenjägers only.
Grüß Gott.
Sind Sie Werner Huber?
Yes. You are an American, eh?
Guess I haven't quite got the accent down, huh? I'm a friend of Gabriel Knight. I'm staying at the castle.
Good.
Well, I came to help him on a case. A Schattenjäger case.
That's a squad.
Well, we got our wires crossed and he'd already left by the time I got here. But Gerda mentioned that he was on a case for you.
No, not for me. For my cousin, Sepp.
Lots of cousins around here. Is Sepp in town?
No. He and his wife went north for a few weeks. We just not live in Rittersberg anyway.
Gerda's not sure where Gabriel is exactly, but you know where I can find him, don't you?
It is not my business to tell people where to find the Schattenjäger. It is maybe not so safe, you see.
Yes, I do see, and I appreciate your caution, really. But we worked together on his last case, and believe me, you'd be doing him a favor.
If he wants you to help him, he will have to contact you at the castle and tell you where he is himself.
Great. Can you tell me what Gabriel's case is about?
What?
Not specifically, of course, but in general. On our last case, we had to deal with a voodoo cult. I was just thinking, if I just knew what he was up against, maybe I could do some research.
Well...
He left so quickly, I guess. He didn't have time to investigate here at all. And the Schattenjäger archives might have something pertinent in them, if I knew what to look for, that is.
Yes, that is true. There is much to be learned from the Schattenjäger past.
Exactly. Gabriel is new at this, you know?
All right, young lady. I will tell you what it is you need to look for.
Yes?
Werewolf.
Werewolf?
Werewolf.
Gabriel's new case involves werewolves?
You don't believe in such things.
I don't know. It's a little outside.
If you truly want to be an aid to a Schattenjäger, you will have to believe in such things. Things that are outside. If you cannot...
All right. A werewolf. What do you know about them? Werewolves, that is.
Some things. This is not the first time that Rittersberg has seen the work of a werewolf, or even a werewolf itself.
Really?
Oh, no, not in my lifetime, you understand. But I was told of it when I was a boy. One was brought to town. It had killed many people. The Schattenjäger caught him. He was tried here.
When was this?
1700s, I think, somewhere around in there.
Tell me about Rittersberg.
It is a small town, private. We keep our business to ourselves.
You mean about the Schattenjägers?
Oh, the Schattenjägers, sure. The Schattenjägers are of this place, and this place is of them. We believe in the old ways here. It has not changed much over the centuries. We still remember what the rest of the world has forgotten.
And that is?
That life is a battle between the light and the dark.
You speak English very well.
Yes.
How did you learn it?
Wolfgang taught some of us.
I never got to meet Gabriel's great uncle. What was he like?
Oh, he was a true Schattenjäger. Like in the old days. He knew things.
What kinds of things?
Things. He had, how do you say it, the sight. He was a very good man to go to when you needed advice.
It must have been hard for the town when Wolfgang died.
Yeah, it was bad, yes. But not a surprise. Gerda knew. It was harder on her than the rest of us.
Really? Were she and Wolfgang close? You said Wolfgang was a true Schattenjäger. I suppose Gabriel... I mean, he's probably not what you expected.
Oh, we shall see with that one. Yeah. One cannot know the quality of the iron until it has been in the fire. Eh? We shall see.
Glitch, a rich half jad lodge, 54 Dina Strasse.
Thomas?
Ja, Thomas hier.
Herr Dr. Klingmann hier. Show our wolves to Mr. Knight?
Ja, okay, Herr Doktor.
I'm afraid I was just about to leave.
Oh, that's all right. Perhaps another day.
Perhaps. Good luck with your work, Mr. Knight. After you.
Oh, hello, Mr. Knight. I have orders to show you one of the wolves.
Really? That would be swell.
Please stay calm and go slow. They don't like strangers. This is a special treat I use to make them come to me. They love it. Marguerite, come here. Come on here, Mädchen. Marguerite, schau mal, was ich hier hab. Na, komm mal hier.
Girl.
Ach, how strange, she likes you.
I have a way with women.
Don't do that. Stop that at once.
Sorry.
Should not have done that, Mr. Knight.
She seems so tame, just like a dog.
Wolf is not dog, Mr. Knight.
Sorry, really.
Yeah. Well, at least nothing happened. Are you done here now?
Yeah, thanks. I'll put in a good word for you with Klingman.
Oh, wunderbar.
Ja?
Herr Knight ist hier, um Sie zu sehen.
Herr Knight? Ach ja.
Ja, schicken Sie ihn doch herein.
Mr. Knight, so good to finally meet you.
Well, it's good to meet you.
Please come in.
Herr Obergrau. Hell, you're just a pop.
I'm sorry. Oh, my age. I hope you're not disappointed.
Oh, me? Nah, I just never had a family lawyer before. I guess I was expecting Matlock or something.
So, you finally decided to visit Munich, yes?
Yep, I'm here doing some research.
Well, anything at all I can do to help. My secretary and I are at your disposal.
Thank you. Is there anything special I should know about Munich?
No, you shouldn't have any problems. You've picked up a little German, haven't you? You've been here, almost a year?
No, I mean, I have been here that long, but my faculty for languages leaves some to be desired.
Well, most Germans speak a little English. If you need anything translated, you can always bring it to me.
Do you know anything about the mutilation killings?
The mutilation killings? Well, no, I... Oh, my God, Herr Knight, is that what you're researching here in Munich? I read your last book, you know.
Really? Well, that's above and beyond the Call of Duty.
Not at all. I love detective fiction. Philip Marlowe, all that. The Voodoo Murders. That was based on a real case, was it not?
Loosely. So you know nothing about the mutilation killings?
Well, only that those missing zoo wolves have attacked and partially eaten people out in the country. If you are researching this case, Herr Knight, I would be happy to assist. It's rather exciting, isn't it? I mean,
do you know anyone with a background in animal biology?
Animal biology for your research?
Right.
Let me think. I have one client who's a professor at the university. Maybe he knows someone there. Let me check. Ja, Herr Dr. Speiger, bitte.
Nur einen Moment.
Herr Dr. Speiger? Ja, wie geht's Ihnen? Ich bin's, Übergrau. Ich bräuchte den Namen eines Experten in Tierbiologie. Oh, das könnte funktionieren. Ja? Ja, sehr gut. Recht herzlichen Dank. Ihnen auch. Auf Wiederhören. So. Kurt, there is a lab at the University Biology Department. They may be able to help you there. Just tell them Herr Dr. Speiger sent you.
Sounds great. Thanks. What is a jagschein? Does that make sense?
Yeah. Jagdschein, it is a permit for killing animals, you know, a sport.
You mean hunting? It's a hunting license?
Yes, hunting license.
What would a zoo official want with a hunting license? Have you ever heard of the Königlich Bayerisch Hofjagdloge?
Königlich Bayerische Hofjagdloge. No, it sounds like a men's sport club.
What does the name translate to exactly?
Oh, the Royal Bavarian Hunting Lodge, more or less.
A hunting lodge, huh? Well, I guess I'd better get going.
Well, enjoy your stay.
Hi, is there someone here that speaks English?
I speak English. Were you looking for the biology lab?
Yes, my name's Gabriel Knight. I was recommended to you by Herr Dr. Spiegel.
My name is Michael. I'll do the work for you.
Could you analyze this hair?
Let's see. What kind of hair is it?
Well, I was kind of hoping you'd tell me.
Probably I can. It's canine, I think. Gray. The tips are lighter, which indicates something with a thick undercoat.
Can you identify the species?
Let me see. Yeah. It's not dog hair. It looks more like wolf. Aha, here it is. Canis lupus lupus, European wolf.
Terrific. Thank you.
No problem.
Could you look at this hair sample now?
Yeah. This is not the same as the other hair.
It isn't.
No, very different. Maybe wolf, though. Same as the other, but not the same species.
Not the same species, are you sure?
Let me see. It's definitely not Canis lupus lupus. It doesn't match any of the other wolf species in the book, either.
It's not dog hair.
So? What is it?
It could be, how do you say, a mix-up?
A mix-up? You mean a hybrid?
Hybrid? Oh, is that when the wolf and the dog, yeah?
Right!
Mm-hmm. Yeah, could be. A hybrid, maybe. Wolf, dog, two wolf species. A wolf and something else. Otherwise, I'm not sure. It's more wolf than dog, but it doesn't match any species in the book, you see?
I see. Thanks. Could you look at a paw print for me?
Sure, okay. God, this is heavy. What is this, cement?
It's all out of plaster Paris.
Then. Yeah. Wolf?
Really, can you tell what species?
It is impossible to tell from a print. Except.
Except?
Yeah, I thought so. It is very big for a wolf. Very big. Looks like maybe 68, 70 kilograms.
That's big for a wolf.
This is huge. Most wolves don't weigh so much as they look. The hair is thicker, which makes them look bigger. But that's why I checked the book. Most species don't get so big.
How big does Canis lupus lupus get?
On average, 38 to 40 kilograms. A North American wolf, 35 kilograms. Only the Alaskan timber wolf maybe gets so big. But even for that species, 70 kilograms would be huge.
Could a hybrid get that big?
Sure. A hybrid might be bigger than a wolf. The other species were big. A very big dog, perhaps. See, the paw print looks like a wolf, but that doesn't mean the whole animal looks like a wolf.
Very interesting. Thanks. I have to go.
Oh, wait a minute. I should give you a report to take with you. Yeah. It summarizes my impressions of the two hair samples and the paw print. Yeah?
Great. I appreciate it.
Good luck, Mr. Knight.
Hallo, meine Damen. Kann ich Ihnen behilflich sein?
Hallo, wie geht es Ihnen?
Gut, danke. Und Ihnen?
Gut. Ich bin hier auf Urlaub und...
Let's try English, shall we?
Yes. I've been studying German at home and I thought I knew a lot, but it's so different now that I'm actually here.
Books alone are poor language teachers. You'll pick it up.
My name is Grace Nakamura. I'm staying at Schloss Ritter. And you are?
You may call me Herr Habermas. Welcome to Rittersberg, Miss Nakamura.
What can you tell me about Rittersberg?
It is a very old town. The walls around it were built in 1438.
Have there always been Ritters in Rittersberg?
Yes, Martin Ritter built the castle in 1223, and the town grew up around it.
What is this building?
This is the Rathaus.
The town hall?
Yes.
Do you keep old town records here? Criminal trial records?
Yes, we have files going back to the 12th century.
Great. Werner Huber told me about a local trial that supposedly involved a werewolf. I'd like to learn more about it.
What was the date?
Sometime in the 1700s.
Let me go look. I heard of this case when I was a boy, but I always thought it was just a scary tale. It never sought to look in the archives. It was there, all right. What did you want to know?
Why did they bring the wolf to Rittersberg? I know the Schattenjäger lived here, but why didn't he just...
kill it where he found it? I don't know. Let's see. Ah, yes. They wanted to know what man it was. Who it was.
They brought it here so it would change back?
Yes, exactly.
Did it change back?
That's what it says. They put the wolf in a cell, and the next morning they found a man in there. A laborer from out of town identified him as Baron von Raleck from Alfing.
Why did they want to find out who the werewolf was?
I would guess... Yes. It says here that a group of villagers were sent to the werewolf's hometown once they learned its human identity.
Why? They thought there were more of them there?
In those days, the family of the identified werewolf would be in great danger. Many believed such curses were handed down through the bloodline.
Where was the werewolf kept while it was here?
The dungeon. There's a dungeon in the rathouse basement. They don't use it anymore, of course.
What happened to the alleged werewolf?
He was interrogated for 2 days. He confessed his guilt. The trial took place on the third day, and he was sentenced to death by quartering and the stake. He was given a final meal. He asked to see a confessor, and this was granted. He died at dawn the following day.
They pulled off his limbs and burned him?
Don't think harshly of us, miss. That was a long time ago. Was there anything else?
I suppose not. Unless, is there any way I could see the dungeon?
It would be my pleasure. Everything's been kept the way it was when the dungeon was in use. We show it off to tourists sometimes. Are you all right, miss?
I'm fine. It's just that this place is so claustrophobic.
I tell you what. Normally this place is locked to keep out the village children. I'll leave it open. You can come and go as you please.
Would you? Thank you so much.
You are most welcome. Goodbye and good luck.
Bye.
Hello again. Did you need something else?
I had a thought while I was in the dungeon.
Yes?
You mentioned that Baron von Raleck was allowed to give a last confession. I suppose the priest was from St. George's?
I suppose it was.
Would there be a record of the last confession? It might tell us more about the Baron's life.
Good idea, young lady. Those records are in German, though, and Father Goetz doesn't speak English. Do you think this would really help your Schattenjäger?
I'm not sure. It couldn't hurt.
All right. I'll write you a note. You give it to Father Goetz, and he'll see if they have a record of the confession. If they do, you bring it back here to me, and I'll help you translate it, okay?
That would be wonderful. Thank you so much.
Certainly. You got my curiosity up too, you know.
I have the church file.
Excellent. Let me see it.
What's this? This is in English. It's from a lawyer in Buenos Aires. It's addressed to St. George's Church. The date is 1764.
What's it say?
It's a request for information about the death of Baron Klaus von Raleck. It says it's for the family. I assume someone answered it. Curious?
What?
The seal on the envelope.
A wolf?
Okay. The last confession. The Raleck family took the symbol of a black wolf to represent their great skill at the hunt. Klaus von Raleck says that he lived up to the family symbol too well. His friends nicknamed him the Black Wolf, but he confessed it was more because he was prideful and treated his villagers and women very badly. He was much feared. The Baron confesses that a life of sin brought the werewolf curse upon him. Ah, listen to this. A gypsy camp, Hungarians, came to Alfing one day. He wanted one of their young women. He had her brought to his castle by force, and there he...
Raped her?
Raped her, yes. He intended to release her, but before he did, the girl killed herself. The next day, an old gypsy woman from the camp cursed him, saying that he was to become the shape that his name and his crimes showed his heart to be.
I see.
Soon afterwards, her curse came about. Klaus von Raleck began to change, to run at night as wolf, to kill and eat human flesh. He begs forgiveness from God and from his wife and son. He says he welcomes his punishment, if only it will pay for his sins and save his family from further pain. That is all that is written.
Wow. Thank you.
I'll return this to Father Goetz for you.
Thank you.
Good luck to you, young lady. And to your Schattenjäger.
Entschuldige Sie bitte, aber das ist ein privater Club.
Guten Tag. Yes.
Oh God, you have mistakenly entered a private establishment.
This is the Koniglitch Bay Richhofter Lodge, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
My name's Gabriel Knight. I'm an avid hunter. I was given your name by a friend.
Really? Tell me more.
Well, me and the boys back home, we're always out shooting them pesky animals. I thought I'd look you up while I was in town, you know, get a few pointers.
Huh. Well, that warms my heart, but I'm afraid you were misled. This is a very exclusive club. We only accept members of very prominent German families.
I am a member of a prominent German family.
Oh, and what family might that be?
My grandfather was one of the Ritters of Rittersberg.
Ritter, I've heard of the name. Can you prove you're a direct descendant?
You're not going to just take my word for it?
No. Do you have proof? That's all the time I'll waste on you, Mr. Knight. Goodbye.
Never mind.
Good. Now please leave.
Ja, das vereinbaren Sie dann am besten mal mit meiner Sekretärin. Gut. Ja, danke. Mr. Knight.
Have a seat, please.
How are you? Would you say the Ritter family tree is respectable?
Absolutely. The Ritters can trace Germanic roots back 1,000 years.
Do y'all have any paperwork on file that would prove that?
Yes, we had to supply a family tree for the title transfer. Would you like a copy?
Please.
Frau Hogel, können Sie mir bitte eine Kopie von dem Familienstammbaum der Ritters für Herrn Knight machen? Schönen Dank.
Thanks.
Bitte schön, Herr Knight. Someone's been using this passageway.
Let me guess. Gerda's bedroom. What a surprise.
Thank you.
books on the occult. Here we go. Vampires, witchcraft, ghosts, Asian spirits. Lycanthropes.
How did you get in here?
Oh, hi.
How did you unlock the door? Oh, I see.
All right. Look, let's just drop all the pretense, okay? Obviously, I found the passageway. I know what's been going on in this little Alpinian love nest, and really, I couldn't care less. If you want to screw around with your employer, that's none of my business. But what I won't put up with is assisting the Schattenjäger crap. I gave up school to work on this stuff because I thought it was important. I'm doing the research that Gabriel wanted, and so help me, I'm going to be doing more than just research this time around. And I'm going to sit around and wait for him to call and give me permission. And if you don't like it, it's just too damn bad!
Okay, fine. You do the damn research. Damn it.
I found a letter in the Werewolf Lore book. It was written by a Schattenjäger, Christian Ritter, to King Ludwig II of Bavaria. It warned him about the Black Wolf. Another Black Wolf? Could this be connected to the case in town? But von Rallich died here in 1750?
Looks like biographies here. I wonder if there's anything on... Yes, Ludwig. König von Bayern, König Ludwig, sein Leben und sein Sieg, die letzten Tage des König Ludwig II. German. That's not much help.
Hello?
Professor Barclay, this is Grace Nakamura. I'm calling from Germany.
Germany? I thought you were in New Orleans.
I was, but anyway, it's rather important or I wouldn't have bothered you. Do you know anything about King Ludwig II of Bavaria?
Well, that's a hell of a thing to ask a man in the middle of the night. Late 1800s, right?
Yes.
This isn't really my field, but I think he was crazy or something.
I wish I knew. Do you know anyone who specializes in German history?
Yeah, I have a friend at the University of Berlin. I'll ring him. What's your number there?
It's 4989-555-7878.
Okay, I'll call you back if I remember this conversation in the morning, anyway.
Great. Sorry again. Thanks. Bye.
Bye.
All right, Knight, I've got your research.
That'll give him something to chew on. Just need somewhere to send it to.
I found the items that Gabriel wanted. Did he tell you where to send your research?
Yes. His lawyer's office in Munich.
Can I get the address?
Harald Übergrau, Marienplatz 21, München.
Thanks.